Nübüvvet, hakikat arayışında peygamber ışığı.
Rabbi şrah li sadri ve yessir li amri ve hlul ukdata min lisani yafqahu qawli. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, let me speak of Sheikh Badiuzzama Sayyid Nursi's Rasale Noor and its comparison with the Risala Takmilul Iman, composed by Sheikh Abdul Haq, the Muhaddis of Delhi in medieval India. Sheikh Abdul Haq Muhaddis in medieval India composed a very brief treatise on the prophethood and its evidences with the title Takmilul Iman in Persian language. The issues and the challenges discussed by the great Muhaddis of Delhi are the same discussed by Sheikh Sayyid Nursi in Risale Noor. But the methodology and the approach adopted by the two great scholars are rather different. Risala Takmilul Iman was written in Persian, and the great Muhaddis has quoted a number of Persian couplets and has used a poetic style to prove the evidences and arguments in favor of the prophethood Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sheikh Sayyid Nursi's language was basically Turkish and sometimes Arabic, and has written in a rational scientific style to prove the prophethood of the last messenger of God sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The methodology applied by the great Muhaddis of New Delhi is a traditional one based mainly upon the Islamic sciences, the Quran, the Hadith, the Fiqh, and has basically avoided any place of reason and intellect in the matters of religion. To him, I quote him from Majma'ul Bahrain, written in Persian. The great Muhaddis says, خوز در فلسفیات و اشتغال بدان حرام دانت و از غلو در مباحثات و دلائل کلامیه اجتناب نمائد و در تفصیل قیل و قال اهل بحث و جدال در نیفتند. The role of reason in the matters of religion was further elaborated by Muhammad Iqbal, a poet, philosopher of modern Indo-Pakistan subcontinent, in his poetry. May I quote few lines from the Urdu poetry composed by Muhammad Iqbal? Khirad se raah rao roshan bashar, khirad se raah rao roshan basar hai, khirad kya hai chiraghe rah guzar hai, درونِ خانہ ہنگامے ہیں کیا کیا، درونِ خانہ ہنگامے ہیں کیا کیا، چراغِ رہ گزر کو کیا خبر ہے، گزر جا عقل سے آگے کی یہ نور، چراغِ راہ ہے منزل نہیں ہے. Move beyond the reason and intellect, because this constitutes a street light and not the destination, as discussed by Muhammad Iqbal. But the methodology applied by Sheikh Badiuzzama Sayyid Nursi is rational, argumentative, and very scientific in nature. I have chosen the ninth droplet from the Risale-e-Noor to discuss the evidences in favor of the prophethood. Sheikh Badiuzama Said Nursi has mainly discussed in this ninth world the 14 droplets. Number one, universality of the messengership, that the Prophet messenger was a universal one. He has quoted a tradition of the Prophet cited by Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayh in his Al-Jami As-Sahih, Bab Qawl al-Nabi Ju'ilat lil-Arz Masjidan wa Tuhura. An Jabirin radiyallahu anhu, qala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, u'titu khamsan lam yu'tahunna ahadun qabli, nusirtu bil-ru'b masirata shahrin, wa ju'ilat lil-Arz Masjidan wa Tuhura. فأيما رجل من أمتي أدركته الصلاة فليصلي وأحلت للغنائم ولم تحل لأحد قبلي وأعطيت الشفاعة وكان النبي يبعث إلى قوم خاصة وبعثت إلى الناس عامة. This hadith was quoted by Sheikh Said Nursi in his favor to prove the universality of the prophethood. Second droplet, as discussed in Risale-e-Noor, is miracles and scriptures narratives of the Prophet of Islam, as well defined in the Holy Quran, when the Holy Quran says, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيَّ الَّذِي يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ. Chapter number 7, verse number 57. The third droplet, as discussed by Shaykh Said Nursi, is the fine character and beautiful form of the Prophet of Islam. It was again defined in the Holy Quran as referred to by Shaykh Said Nursi in Risale-e-Noor. قُلْ لَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا تَلَوْتُهُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَلَا أَدْرَاكُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ لَبِسْتُ فِيكُمْ عُمُرًا مِّن قَبْلِهِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Chapter number 10, verse 16. The fourth droplet discussed in the form of the evidences favor of the prophethood is harmony and coordination in this universe as predicted by the Prophet of Islam in the Holy Quran as well as in the traditions. The Holy Quran very clearly categorically defined, وَإِمْ مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ حَلِيمًا غَفُورًا. Verse number 17. Chapter 17, verse 44. وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. But you don't understand the tasbih of this whole universe is more significant in the writings of the Shaykh Badiuzama Said Nursi's Risale-e-Noor, which has been discussed and elaborated in length in pages and pages by the learned scholar. The fifth droplet, as discussed by Shaykh Badiuzama Said Nursi in favor of prophethood, is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as being a petted monarch, a spoiled vicegerent on the earth, as clearly defined in the Quran itself. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. The man is created in the best form, in the best molds. Man as such entitles to all the dignities and respects as elaborated by the Prophet of Islam sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A very important point elaborated by Shaykh Badiuzama Said Nursi in his writings. Then again, the Holy Quran says, Inni ja'ilun fil ard khalifa, vicegerent of God. Every human being if he performs his noble duties towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and towards the human beings. The sixth droplet, as discussed by Shaykh Sayyid Nursi in the Risal-e-Noor, is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, an exemplar of mercy, a model of love, a glory of mankind, as very clearly defined in Risal-e-Noor. The Holy Quran says, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nazira wa da'iyan ila Allahi bi iznihi wa sirajan munira. Chapter 33, verse 45. The seventh droplet, as discussed in the Risal-e-Noor in the 19th world, is the inward revolution brought by the Prophet of Islam through his mission and unmatched personality. Mission and the personality, both equally important. Not only the message, but even the great personality of the Prophet of Islam. Since the followers of Islam not only love, not only have a great affection to his message, but even his great personality. So the personality and the message, both discussed in the Holy Quran as a proof, a clear evidence in favor of the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Holy Quran says, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. Chapter 3, verse 159. Very important aspect and dimension of the Prophet of Islam, who was the harbinger of a true democracy, a true constitutionalism in the world history. Go through this verse quoted by Shaykh Sayyid Nursi. This elaborates how the Prophet consulted frequently with his companions. The earth droplet, as discussed in the 19th world, is the Arabian Peninsula, as a model for change and reformation. He has presented and addressed those who refuse to accept the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. See, go through the Arabia, how it was changed totally, inwardly as well as outwardly, into a new form, into a new revolution. The Holy Quran itself admits, وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ مَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَىٰ شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِّنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. Chapter 3, verse 103. The ninth droplet, as discussed in the Risal-e-Noor, is the fact that there is no contradiction in the character of the Prophet of Islam. You will find a truthful, an honest, an integrated personality who always keeps his words, not only in the matters of the revelation, but even in the matters of his personal life. The Holy Quran itself admits, when it declares, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا أَوْ قَالَ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ وَلَمْ يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ شَيْءٌ وَمَنْ قَالَ سَأُنْزِلُ مِثْلَ مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ. Chapter 6, verse 93. The 10th droplet in the 19th word, as discussed by Shaykh Badiuzzaman Sayyid Nursi, is the predictions of the doomsday, last day, by the Prophet of Islam. Yakunun nasukal farashil mafsus ila akhiril ayah. This interesting aspect of the prophethood was further elaborated and theorized by a contemporary scholar of Egypt, Sayyid Qutb of Al-Ikhwan Al-Muslimun, in his famous book, Mashahidul Qiyamati Fil Qur'an Al-Kareem. The 11th droplet, as discussed in the Risale-Nur, in favor of the prophethood, is that the prophet exposed the wonders of the universe. An unschooled man who never attended any school exposed the wonders, philosophical, economic, social, and scientific wonders of the universe. The Holy Quran itself predicted and clearly defined, قُلْ رَبِّ إِمَّا تُرِيَنِّي مَا يُوعَدُونَ رَبِّ فَلَا تَجْعَلْنِي فِي الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ وَإِنَّا عَلَىٰ أَن نُرِيَنَّكَ مَا نَعِدُهُمْ لَقَادِرُونَ. Al-Quran 23, verse number 93. The 12th droplet, as discussed in the Risale-Nur, is that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a true guide for eternal happiness, who that was beautifully portrayed in the Holy Quran itself. Eternal, a source of eternal happiness, very important. The Quran has discussed those who will enter paradise on the day of judgment, how they will be respected fully by Almighty God. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفَتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ تِبْتُمْ فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. The 13th droplet, only 2 minutes, please. The 13th droplet, as discussed in the Risale-Nur, is the worship of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, worship of God as done by the Prophet of Islam, was a reason to the next world. How the Prophet worshipped, though he was a masoom and innocent. It has been discussed by Shaykh Sayyid Nursi as a reason to the next world. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ تَقُومُ أَدْنَى مِنْ ثُلُثَيِ اللَّيْلِ وَنِصْفَهُ وَثُلُثَهُ وَطَائِفَةٌ مِّنَ الَّذِينَ مَعَكَ وَاللَّهُ يُقَدِّرُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ. It has been admired by the Holy Quran itself. And the last, but not the least, is the miraculousness of the Holy Quran. Inimitable position of the Holy Quran that challenged the Meccan pagans again and again to produce a book or some verses of a book or few chapters like that of the Holy Quran, but they were failed to do it. قُلْ لَيْنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ زَهِيرًا. So these 14 droplets, as discussed by Shaykh Badiuzzaman Sayyid Nursi, give a very clear picture, a very sound argument in favor of the prophethood. This was discussed by Shaykh Muhaddis of Delhi in his Risala Takmilul Iman also. But the difference between the two is that the methodology and approach by the great Muhaddis was very, very traditional. He was against the role of reason in the matters of religion. The methodology applied by Shaykh Badiuzzaman Sayyid Nursi is rational and scientific. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم أجمعين واستغفروه innahu huwal ghafurur rahim wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
İstanbul İlim ve Kültür Vakfı.